Welcome to episode 12 of The Longest Journey. I'm your host, Lost Wolf, and when last we left you, we were here, and I said that there was a bunch of stuff we need to do, the first thing of which is we need to turn this light off. We need to go and visit his little thing here.
It's a loose shard of the mirror glass. I'll just carefully separate this shard from the mirror. Like so. I'll have to be careful carrying this around. Archives login. F. Minelli. Password, wife's birthday. What a smart boy. Real security whiz.
Okay, so now that we got that, we're going to do a silly slash funny thing. Now, the thing that I was worried about, the thing that was going to crash the game, happens here. And it did, in fact, crash the game. What I had to do was I had to download one of the game's files and replace it, so that it would work again. And that might be the solution for you if you're playing this along at home and this happens to crash your game. There are other solutions, lots of them, but this is the one that worked for me. So if you go out here, it's going to trigger a cutscene. And when you come back from the cutscene, if you try going back here, it will crash at exactly this spot. So what you need to do is, there's a file called 01.xarc. If you find a new version of that on the internet, I found one at the GOG forums, so that would be your best place to look. I will put a link in the description below for those of you who are playing along at home and want the file. All you have to do is literally, I renamed the old file and replaced the new file with that one, and it should work. It doesn't always, there were other solutions, but there you go. So here we go, cutscene.
This is Lucinda Carlisle reporting live from just outside the Metro Precinct Police Station, and I bring you today a senseless and tragic display of technology gone wrong. In the carnage you see behind me, medical drones are digging through the rubble of a crashed shuttle for the remains of over 100 people who lost their lives today in an accident that could and should have been prevented. Only hours ago, a brave new World Airlines shuttle carrying starry-eyed colonists to the Metro Tower experienced an engine failure and came roaring down on this street without warning, crushing three cars and burying nine innocent pedestrians and two would-be carjackers. The cause of this human tragedy? As of yet, there is no official report. We can only speculate, and speculate we will.
Here we go.
Was the pilot drunk? Was he hopped up on Amethyst? Was someone aboard carrying a bomb? Did the manufacturers of the shuttle, Monster Limited, skimp on a part and import it from a bootleg factory in Germany? The truth could be any or all of the above. But whoever is responsible, and whatever the punishment, it won't bring any of those bloody, mangled corpses to life. It won't bring Teresa Roseman, mother of three, back to her husband, Marty. That loss is forever, and a huge cash settlement can only ease the pain. It can never remove it altogether. Only expensive brain surgery and personality modification through proprietary drugs can do that. The exact death count is still under wraps, and work will continue throughout the day to identify the thousands of body parts that are being picked one by one from the twisted wreckage of BMWA Shuttle 709. What repercussions will this accident have on our city? Probably none. You fly a shuttle, you take your chances. This is Lucinda Carlisle.
Okay, now beware. She's gonna start swearing like a trooper.
Back to you, Lisa and Dan. Are we clear? How did I do? Uh-huh. And what are the ratings?
Mission 5.
5 million? That's it? 5 million? Jesus, we've lost out to reruns of Gillian's Island.
That's amazing.
What the fuck, Gregory? Why the hell did you... Yeah, don't give me any of that shit. You were the one who said this would broaden my audience. I should have stuck with the game shows. Jesus!
I love that. They lost out to Gilligan's Island reruns. That's amazing. Anyway, so this is... I don't know if anyone was watching, but April was dancing in the background and being silly, and that's also amazing. So anyway, you come back this way. We needed to trigger that cutscene, but anyway, we've done it, so that's good. Oh, wait, no, I lie. Oh my goodness. What am I doing? We don't go to the police station right yet. we go this way. If, oh, also, if you have trouble with that cutscene breaking the game, one thing that you can do is, once the cutscene is done, you can always come back and go back in through the garbage disposal, and that seems to work alright. Okay, so we need to go to the radio station. And why, you ask, we need to go to the radio station? Well, it wasn't completely obvious the first time Manelli sneezed, but his eye comes out whenever that happens. So we know where we can get a spare eye from, and it's Constable Guybrush. We left Constable Guybrush over here. So we're going to go grab that. And here's our faithful friend, Constable Guybrush. Okay. Thank you, Constable Guybrush, for your eye.
It's a great, big eye on a spring. Sorry, Guybrush, but I need to borrow your eye for a while.
Okay. And out we go. And now we have to go back. And the unfortunate thing, of course, is that naturally, when you go back, you have to do the whole thing with the door again. Which is silly, but there you go. To the subway. To Metro West, of course. Now, in theory, the game should not crash. If it does crash, I'm going to be very unhappy. But it survived my test playthrough of this episode, so we should be good. Yeah, just never know. This is going to be a shortish episode, by the way, because we're going to meet Flipper Burns at the end of this. It's a little bit of a spoiler, but eh. And the thing about Flipper Burns is that I need to put a warning up before we meet him. Oh boy, do I ever. So this is going to be a short-ish episode, probably on the order of like, not quite 10 minutes, 15 minutes at the most.
Excuse me, ma'am.
You again, what do you want now?
I'd like that form for complaining about lewd and indecent behavior, please.
Number?
31366.
Hold on.
Okay, now we can go through without her hassling us. Excellent. Do we need to go this way? Now the thing is, we need to know Manelli's birthday, wife's birthday. So we have to talk to him about that.
How's Mrs. Manelli doing?
Why are you asking? I didn't think it... Hell, Maria, we spoke about this. I told you, Can't you just let it rest?
Sure, sorry. Just... wondering.
I wish you wouldn't, Maria. You know how... It is what it is, you know?
About Miss Manelli.
About Mrs. Manelli.
God damn it, Maria, I'm on the freaking can, yeah?
I was just thinking, maybe I should get her a birthday present. What do you think?
Are you nuts? Have you gone completely nuts? What are you doing? What the hell are you doing?
Being nine?
Nice! You want Laura to kick me out of my own apartment? Is that it? You want my wife to kick me out of the apartment tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Your wife's birthday's tomorrow?
You're not buying her a present, Maria. Don't even think about it. That would be such a big mistake. You don't want to make a mistake like that.
Okay, boss. You're the boss.
Don't call me boss. And would you leave me alone? I'm not in a sociable mood. Hell, I'm on the can.
Gotta go, Manelli.
Thanks for your help, Maria. Phew. Jesus, I think I'm allergic to the goddamn medicine.
Now watch the floor very carefully. Okay, there we go. So, we need to replace his eye with Constable Guybrush's eye. Which is mean, but we need the eye.
seeing red. I'm having a stroke. Maria, go get the doctor fast. I'm seeing red.
Oh. I realize it's pretty mean, but there you go. Right, and here we go. We are not quite at the end of the episode, but we're very close now. And we got a couple more things to do. And just like that, we gain access to the archives. It took like an episode and a bit, but we're here. Right. Computer time.
Hi, I'm Frank Minnelli. And I feel really guilty doing this. I love my wife Laura, and her birthday is on the 31st of this month, which means... Laura 0731? Please.
So we know now, canonically, that this is the...
Yes, I'm so good again. Now, what to search for?
The 31st of July, 22, whatever it is. Okay, so we got a bunch of things here. We got Warren News, Vanguard, Church of Voltec, Abel Ryan, Erica Hughes, and Logoff. Let's search for ourselves first.
I'm just gonna make sure there's no warrant or anything out for my arrest.
Very good. Now, one thing that I do want to point out, and I'm going to do this again
so
you can see.
Anything out for my arrest.
Notice how her name is in capital letters. And every other name that we're going to type is not.
It's a long shot, but...
No capital letters. No information available. Okay, so let's do the things that we came for. We came for Warren Hughes. And this is Warren's rap sheet. He's got a rap sheet
and I'm
long.
More of Warren's rap sheet. He's been kinda active.
So we got a couple of things here. We can edit his rap sheet or we can delete it. I think it's safest. Well, I haven't tried it yet.
I'll just make a few small changes. Nothing major. That's much better. Scary how easy it is to manufacture a saint.
You can also just delete.
Whoa! I think I just killed Warren. Oh,
there you
well.
Go.
He's just gonna have to live with that. At least the cops and corporates won't be after him anymore. Just the morgue.
So there's two choices here. You can either edit it or you can delete it. Deleting it, I think, makes his life a little bit easier. Because he's dead, so they're not actually gonna come and look for him. But if he's alive, then obviously they are going to, you know, come and look after him, look for him.
Warren's sister, and that's her colonization number. I'd better remember it in case I need it.
Okay, so now we need to print out what we have.
Presses are rolling. Now, where's the printer?
I love the old sound of this printer that they used here. Okay, let's go with Erica Hughes.
Warren's sister. Please let.
But of course, under Erica Hughes, she doesn't really exist anymore, so we need to go and use her colonization number.
It's the only lead I have, so if this falls through, I'm out of luck.
There we go. But
I better get a hard copy of this for Warren.
The important thing to notice here is that she ended up being adopted. Adopted by Lieutenant Carol Drake, OABM Prime. On blah 2208 after death of parents. Her parents are both dead, as we can see over there in the records. And we need to look up the Church of Voltec.
The Church of Voltec is the front of the Vanguard use here in Stark, so there must be at least some information available.
Okay. I'm gonna read this up because this is the only thing that's sort of important and is story relevant. We will never meet Warren Hughes again. His part in the story is over. But we know exactly what we need to know about Warren. This is all important. So, Revolutionary Church, there. Registered trademark of the Revolutionary Church Holdings. registered to as organized religious movement under the Manu Memorandum 09301-01012113. The information protected and classified under the Religious Secrecy Act, the Manu Memorandum 09342. All inquiries to be directed to the Revolutionary Church. Contact White Cardinal, that's an interesting name for him, Jacob McCallan. We've heard his name once before, and we heard it, unfortunately, a little spoilerifically when we were talking to Warren. So, this is Jacob.
Jacob McCallan. White Cardinal? What the hell is that? I should keep that name in mind, though. It could turn out to be important.
Okay, so, let's go and look for Jacob McCallan.
The so-called White Cardinal.
Item classified. This request has been logged. User Frank Minnelli has violated user privileges. Frank Minnelli, please report to supervisor. He's probably about to lose his job, but we need to press on, so we're going to continue. We don't get anything, really. We just get these four symbols. And I'm pleased to see that they're same as the ones in my test playthrough. Neither do I. Okay. We need to log off, and we will collect our two pieces of paper. And then we'll mess with this console over here. Now this console's got these funny glyph things on it. And what we need to do is we need to match up what we saw to retrieve the particular parcel of information about Jacob. So we're going to do this. You won't see anything telling you that you're driving quickly. You'll just hear a little plip. And that means that you've pressed a button. You can only press 4, so each time you do, you will reset this console. So there. And then here. And there. Green means you're right. Red means you're not. Down, of course.
There's nothing in here. Oh, except for a tiny data cube.
Okay.
It's a tiny data cube with a non-standard interface. It probably won't work on the screen we have at home.
And
it's Frank Minnelli's synthetic eye. I'm just, borrowing it. He'll get it back. It's the hard copy of all the information Warren wanted on his sister and himself.
Okay, so out we go. And we can now head back to Warren and we can give him what we have. I'm always terrified that when I walk out here the game is gonna crash. Street. Oh, I just lost my notes. They fell onto the floor. Just a second. I will be right back while I retrieve them. Not that I actually need them for the rest of the episode, because the rest of the episode is fairly self-explanatory. We need to go to Hope Street, of course. And we need to visit one. So,
how did it go? Did you get the information? Is my sister okay?
It wasn't easy, but I did it. Your sister's fine. You don't have to worry about the law or the corporates anymore.
That's great. That's... Thank you. Really. Thank you. So do you have the information for me?
Sure, right here. Listen, Warren. Your parents. They're dead. But your sister's okay. She's been adopted by some woman named Drake, a lieutenant with the Wakamba Mercer Corporation.
My sister's a corp brood? And my parents. You know that should hurt, but it doesn't. I don't feel anything. My parents left me a long time ago. But my sister, I gotta find her.
I'm sure you will, Warren.
Hey, wait a minute. You killed me? Thanks a lot.
Well, when you're dead, nobody cares. The cops are not gonna be chasing after you for crimes committed by a dead guy.
Yeah, you're right. I'm gonna have a tough time getting a new ID. You should have just wiped my record clean. I'm not complaining, though. I'm better off now than I was a few hours ago. So what can I do for you now, sister?
So, here's why I say that I think it's better off that he's dead. Because he's forced to get a new ID. The new ID means that he's going to get a new ID number. And of course it's going to be that much trickier for the corporates and the cops to trace him. So, in a sense, he gets off with a little bit more than... He gets away with a little bit more than he needs to.
Can you put me in touch with your friend now?
Yeah, for the information you needed? Right, you got it. Head on out to the Newport docks, down in the outskirts of the city. It's all deserted now since they stopped using the boats for cargo shipments. Head across the construction yard to a large garage. You can't miss it. It's got all these large tubes outside. Knock 3 times on the door, and tell Burns Flipper. This guy's weird, so don't mind the stuff he says. Tell the Flipper that I sent you. I'll call ahead to let him know you're coming. He should be able to help you out with almost everything you need to know, okay?
Thanks.
Okay, there was a...
Bye, Warren.
Hey.
Diary entry up there. We're going to go and check that in a minute. I'm going to take us to the Newport docks. I'm not going to take us right to the Flipper, but I'm going to get us to the Newport docks. We'll read the diary entry while we're here, while we're there. Oh boy, Flipper. The Newport docks. Now, the first time I saw this when I was playing the game originally, I was not sure where to go to get to Flipper, but we need to go there. But first, we're going to read April's diary. We read that. His sister and parents were sent to the colonies, and he wants to find out where they went. So I have to dig through the police archives to get a hold of whatever information I can. At the same time, while I'm in there, I should also look up the Vanguard, or the Church of Voltec, which is like their cover here in Stark. Still Sunday. Surprise! I got in. I got out. I got a glorious career in crime ahead of me if I want. And it feels so good. My parents would be so proud of me. Little Miss Criminal. That's me. Whatever. At least I got the name and location of Warren's friend and friend, the so-called Burns Flipper. Is that an actual name? His shop is down by the Newport docks in an old garage. Knocked 3 times on the door, Warren told me. I'm surprised I don't have to say open sesame as well. Hopefully this guy, Flipper, will be able to help me locate the Vanguard Church of Voltec. This afternoon I have to meet up with Cortez again, and I'd prefer to have some solid information to share with him. And that's about where we're going to call it. I will see you all tomorrow when we pick up from where we left off. This is me having a crashy time, so I'm going to save over that. Thank you so much for joining me. I've been your host, Lost Wolf. I shall see you all soon. Have a great evening, folks, and goodbye.